Hi guys, my name is Michna and I'm the engineering manager on Cadence. And I guess once in a while in my spare time, I moonlight as like a demo developer. So we're gonna revisit this Uber Eats use case again, and we'll show you how we can implement that as a workflow. So one more time, I guess it's a sequence of seven steps, right? So the first step is somebody places an order through the app and then the order gets sent over to the restaurant for confirmation. Once the restaurant confirms it, we can compute an ETA of when we should dispatch a driver. And then we can schedule a timer to let us do that dispatch at the appropriate time. once that time comes, we can go ahead and dispatch a courier to pick up the order. And then we want to register that pickup. And in this case, we want both the courier to confirm that they picked up the order and the restaurant to confirm the same thing. And once the order is picked up, we want to register that it was delivered successfully so that we can charge the end customer. So just to give you an idea how we model this, we have the overall order workflow, which as the first step triggers a sub workflow, which we call the place order workflow, which has two activities, one to send the order to restaurant and wait for confirmation. The second one to estimate the ETA. Then we have a timer, one of those durable timers that Maxim told you guys before about. And once that timer fires, we can schedule the deliver order sub workflow, which now has three activities. The dispatch courier activity, where we want the courier to confirm that he accepts this dispatch. The pickup order confirmation activity and deliver order confirmation activity. And once that sub workflow finishes, we can go ahead and schedule an activity to charge the user. So to demo this workflow, basically we built three UI apps, right? So on the left-hand side is where we place the order and where we're gonna follow along with the status of the order. On the top right side, that's the restaurant app where the restaurant will receive the order. And at the bottom, and the bottom right side is the courier app where the courier is able to accept the order and also perform the other confirmation operations. So let's go ahead and pick a couple of items from the menu. And click place order. So as soon as I click that button, our UI called into the Cadence service and triggered a Uber Eats order workflow, right? And automatically the first step or the first sub workflow gets launched, and now we're in the pickup order activity. And this is what we call an asynchronously completed activity, meaning the activity, the first thing it does, it sends the order over to the restaurant service. And then it exits with a special code that tells Cadence, hey, I need to receive some other signal for me to complete. So this is how we are able to receive the signal from the restaurant, whether they accept or decline the order. So I'm gonna go ahead as the restaurant person and accept the order. As soon as I click that button, a signal gets sent over to the Cadence service. As you can see, that order activity completed, and we immediately launch the estimate ETA activity. So now the whole order workflow has completed and we're in the state where now we have an estimate for when we need to dispatch the driver. Because I don't want to wait for the 20 minutes or whatever the estimate was, and also an interesting feature for the restaurant would be, what if the estimate was wrong and they prepared the food, the dish much quicker? Now they have an option to tell us, hey, the food is ready. So this is implemented as a signal operation. And what that lets us do is like we send another bit of information to the workflow and we can cancel that timer and proceed. So the reason why that thing turned purple is because it's a cancel timer now. So now we're in the order workflow operation. As you can see down here in the courier service, we managed to send the order to the courier for dispatch. So let's say that I'm a courier who is busy right now or I'm about to go offline. So I'm not gonna accept this order. I'm gonna go ahead and decline. Because this is a pretty idempotent operation, I can redispatch to a different courier. I can simply just implement a very basic retry logic by just saying redispatch, basically re-execute this activity again. So you see that we recorded the failure of the first one, but we executed another instance of this activity. And let's assume this is a different courier now, which decides to accept this thing. So the courier accepted and he is on his way to the restaurant. As soon as he gets there, he goes, picks up the order, and now he can click this order picked up button. And as you can see, the activity completed, but what's going on with our workflow? Why is the next activity not proceeding? So this is because we wanted to implement sort of double acceptance. And we also need the restaurant to click that order is out for delivery button before we proceed in the workflow. Once the restaurant does that, immediately we schedule the last activity in the order flow or the delivery flow, which is we're waiting for the confirmation that the order was delivered. So once the courier delivers the order, he can click that delivered order button and the workflow proceeds to the last step, which is figure out what we need to charge and go ahead and charge the customer for the order. So another little bit I'm going to mention. So all this stuff on the left-hand side is generated based on the history that Cadence keeps of this workflow. All those boxes are just generated by parsing this long history that was generated during the execution.